Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. In today's video, we are going to dive into response caching in .NET 8 Web API. If you have already watched my previous video on output caching, you might be wondering, why bother with response caching when we already have output cache? Well, stick around because today we will talk about why response caching is an absolute game changer for optimizing your APIs. Imagine your web API handling thousands of requests per minute. If you are repeatedly fetching the same data, like user profile or public data, or let's say a static data which does not change, wouldn't it be amazing if you could save those responses and serve them directly instead of hitting your database each time? That is where response caching comes in. It stores a copy of your API response for future requests, allowing you to reduce load on your server and significantly boost performance. Let me quickly clarify this. While output cache targets server-side processing, storing the output generated by the server for a specific user request, response caching focuses on client-side and intermediary caching. This means with response caching, you are allowing client to store and reuse API responses for a given time, making it incredibly efficient for public or frequently accessed data. So whether you are building a public-facing API or working on a performance-critical project, response caching is a critical tool in your API optimization toolkit. Let's dive in and see how we can implement this in .NET 8. So I have a default project created, and in here, in order for you to integrate response caching, it's quite simple. Two steps. The first step is to register the service. The second step is to use the service, and that is all. So go to your program.cs file. As you can see, I have an API. That is where we are focusing on. And in here, let's add this response cat service. So once you're done with this, you go to your controller and also use a service. So when you check here, you can see I have a response cache and it takes in a duration of 60 seconds. So it tells you that the response that is coming from here will be cached on the client for 60 seconds. And aside from that, it will be erased and the new one also set in. So all the time, try to cache requests or try to cache responses which do not often change. Before we test this application, I want us to comment this response caching. You know, when we run this a couple of times, each request is going to give us a different value, isn't it? Now with a response caching, as soon as we integrate it or we activate this one, it will take 60 seconds before a new request or a new data will pop up. Within that 60 seconds, it's going to be having the data which was cached. So we're going to have that data repeatedly until that 60 seconds elapses. Let's try this and testify what I'm talking about. Then we activate the response cache. So we have our controller ready. Let's focus on this weather forecast. Now from this weather forecast, if I click on try this out, the first time that it makes this request, we're going to have the date in here and at the temperature and on the both temperatures, right? The C Celsius and the Fahrenheit, you can see we have 2373 for each. If I click on execute next one, you can see it has changed from 1558. So every request that you make is going to hit your controller and call the same process, the same function again. So as you can see, it keeps changing. Now let's go and activate this response caching. So let's go ahead and try this out. So from this, execute this for the first time, we have 45 and 112. Let's make another request, because you have the same 45 and 112. unless the 45 or the 60 seconds elapses before this will reset and I'll get us a new set of record. Let's see. So you can see it's still giving us the same thing. Now we're going to wait for 60 seconds. Then let's see whether we're going to have a new one. Yes, and we have it. You can see it has changed. Now this is also going to persist for 60 seconds. And you can see it is the same. So that is the simplest way of integrating response caching. Take note that when you want to integrate response caching, it caches responses on the client side. And if you want to use an output caching, it caches this response on the server side. So based on your scenario, you choose the caching method which is suitable for your application. I hope this helps you understand how powerful response caching can be in boosting your API performance. If you find this video helpful or useful, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and also subscribe for more tips and tutorials on optimizing your .NET project. If you have any questions too, you can put them in the comment below. Until next time, keep coding and keep building amazing things.